Hello, I'm Mark Wild, Chief Executive of HS2. I'm here at our head office in Houston today, and I wanted to take this opportunity as we begin the second half of 2025 to provide an update on the work we're doing to deliver HS2. Across 140 miles of the route, our expert teams are working hard every single day to deliver what is the biggest upgrade to our rail network in over 100 years. A project that will shape the country's future. We have made significant construction progress this year, but we've also had to face some hard facts. In my last update, I set out the challenges that this project has faced and the work we're doing this year to reset the HS2 program. Through the first phases of the reset, I have shared my initial assessment of the program with the Department for Transport and the government and set out three clear priorities for HS2 this year: improving control, boosting safety and productivity, and delivering the reset. The government's commitment to the project in the recent spending review, alongside the appointment of Mike Brown as our new chair, provide greater certainty to the delivery of this program. I'm really excited to see Mike join the project. He brings with him a wealth of experience over multiple decades managing, operating, delivering major transportation schemes in the UK. Our focus is to create a clear, realistic budget and timeline for HS2 that the government supports, and to ensure that we deliver the transformational benefits of economic growth and vital new rail capacity between our two biggest cities. While we resequence the program, we're focused on essential work that safely accelerates construction and supports the reset, laying secure foundations for the future delivery of the program. In 2018, before construction began, we set out our plan to address the UK's skills shortages, invest in future talent, and help those living near the line of route to start new careers. Today, 7 years later, more than 33,000 people are working on HS2. Over 1,800 apprenticeships have been created, and over 5,000 previously unemployed people have secured work on the project. The jobs and career opportunities supported by HS2 will underpin the construction industry for years to come. It provides a boost to regional economies along the West Midlands to London corridor and supports the government's drive to get Britain building and get more people into work. Every day at HS2, career-defining milestones are being achieved by our exceptional teams, working together to overcome challenges and progress our civils and stations construction programme. At the end of the line, HS2's four stations, Birmingham Curzon Street, Interchange in Solihull, Old Oak Common in West London, and London Euston will be transport superhubs, putting hundreds of destinations within easy reach for millions of customers. At Old Oak Common, installation of the first high-speed platforms has started, a major milestone for the station site and the one that gives us a glimpse of what the future passengers can expect when services are running. When complete, the station will be one of the best connected in the UK. In the West Midlands, we welcomed Birmingham City Council's recent approval of our enhanced designs for the new flagship terminus station at Curzon Street. Work continues at pace on the foundations, and our station's partner is focused on finalising the details of the design before construction of the station building starts next year. This is a good example of getting design right so that construction can proceed productively. More than 45 miles, or 82%, of our new rail tunnels have now been excavated. Four of our huge tunnel boring machines have completed their drives this calendar year alone. Our longest tunnel and our shortest tunnel are both structurally complete. Tunnel boring machine Elizabeth, currently digging the second bore of the Bromford Tunnel in Birmingham, is due to complete her drive later this year. And our London Tunnels team are preparing to launch our final two TBMs, Karen and Madeline, which will start mining towards Euston next year. Above ground, our bridges and viaducts continue to take shape across the route. In the West Midlands, our teams are using several different techniques to lift, lower, push and slide the network of viaducts that will carry our trains safely across motorways, roads, rivers, and floodplains into position. This process is replicated across the 50-mile section between Northamptonshire and the North Chilterns, with the decks of three key viaducts launched into position this year, and the piers, beams, and concreting at many of the viaducts is also progressing well. Many key bridges are also taking shape, which will not only enable HS2 trains to travel safely beneath, but also provide much needed upgrade to local road networks near the line of route. A key focus for us this year is our Earthworks program, critical to the successful delivery of our entire civils construction activity. This is the process of excavating material to create the space below ground level where the railway will run in cuttings, and using that same material to build embankments which will carry the line above ground. The warmer weather so far in 2025 has enabled our construction partners to make good progress so far. With our extensive fleet of construction vehicles working hard every single day to lift and fill materials to connect our tunnels, bridges and viaducts together. As part of our bridge air activities, we are providing our earthwork teams with all the support that they need to progress their work safely and productively. The work we do this year across the route is critical for us to prove to the government and taxpayers that we can build the high-speed railway the country deserves. We understand the scale of the challenge and the necessity to get the reset right. We're not just building HS2, we're building the future of UK infrastructure. I understand the responsibility to get this right. Every task we complete safely and efficiently will take us closer to completing the railway. Even before trains start running, investment around HS2 stations in the West Midlands and in West London is forecast to inject £20 billion into the economy in the next 10 years alone. This is happening right now, while we're constructing, a real boost of confidence to the eventual outcome of this fantastic programme. The prize is clear: better growth, better journeys. I understand the responsibility we have, though, to get the reset right and break the cycle of continual cost increases and delays. That's what we're committed to do. Thank you for watching. I look forward to bringing you further updates as we continue to deliver Britain's new high-speed railway.